Today, we gather here to mark the culmination of an incredible journey with the closing ceremony of the All India IPSC Boys Squash Tournament 2023. It is with great pleasure and honor that I, Samira Singh, head girl of the school, stand before you as we reflect upon passion, skill, and sheer determination that have been on display throughout the course of this tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an immense honor to have amongst us Colonel Raj Singh Bishnoi, Senior Executive Director, Netaji Subhash National Institute of Sport, as our chief guest for the day. Commissioned in Rajputana Rifles in the year 1990 as second lieutenant, Sir has had a glorious stint in the Indian Army for 28 years. He had the honour to operate in Kashmir during the peak of insurgency and played a vital role during the infamous Kargil War of 1999. In addition to this, as a qualified helicopter pilot, he carried out 2,500 hours of operational flying in various areas of the country. A national medalist in basketball, Sir also served as the principal and director, Sports School Drive, Government of Haryana. Finally, Sir took over as the present senior executive director at Sports Authority of India, Netaji Subhash National Institute of Sport, Government of India. The Netaji Subhash National Institute of Sport has been the leading institute of sport in not only India, but Asia too. The impact of NIS Patiala on the Indian sports scene cannot be overstated. From Olympic medalists to Asian Games champions, the names that have emerged from NIS Patiala continue to inspire generations to pursue their dreams in the realm of sport. NIS has also been a pillar of support to the vital sporting community since decades. To commence with today's program, we first have a budding musician presenting before you a fusion of Western and Indian classical music. We have Virat Singh on the drums, Avraj Manchanda as our guitarist, Jenny Bradley shall be playing the piano, Dhruv Jindu as our bass guitarist, Virat Singh Sidhu on the guitar, and Dhruvi Jain and Abhinav Deep Singh Jain as our vocalist.
Thank you.
for that. Thank you. Thank you for that mesmerizing performance. Next up, we have one of our eloquent dancers, Priya Indris, performing the solo semi-classical dance piece. Squash, often referred to as the game of giants, has a rich history dating back centuries. Originating in the United Kingdom, it has grown into a global phenomenon, captivating players and spectators alike with its intensity and strategic brilliance. As we witnessed the matches unfold over the course of this IPSC tournament, we were reminded of the dedication, perseverance, and agility required to excel in this demanding sport. Beyond physical prowess, squash teaches us invaluable life lessons. It inculcates in us the importance of discipline, teamwork, and sportsmanship. The true essence of the sport lies not only in victory or defeat, but in the journey itself. Each point played, each rally fought, and each match contested is an opportunity for growth, for self-discovery, and for forging lifelong friendships. To the players sitting here, we salute you for your unwavering commitment to the game. Each one of you has spent countless hours honing your skills, pushing your limits, and overcoming obstacles to reach the position you are at today. Your dedication is a testament to the indomitable human spirit, inspiring all those who witness the electrifying matches. Today, as we mark the end of this tournament, I would like to take this moment to recognize the efforts of those who have worked tirelessly to ensure that every aspect of this tournament was executed flawlessly. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to the organizers and school staff who have worked relentlessly to bring this tournament to fruition. It is their hard work that has allowed us to witness this grand spectacle of talent. Let us acknowledge their efforts with a round of applause. Furthermore, I would be remiss if I didn't express our gratitude to the coaches and officials of the various teams under whose expertise and motivation which has been monumental towards the success of their players and school teams. As we applaud the winners and acknowledge their remarkable achievements, let us also pay tribute to every single participant who has taken part in this tournament. Every player, regardless of the outcome, has contributed to the electrifying atmosphere that has filled the Nalagarh squash courts in our premises. Their sportsmanship truly elevated the spirit of this event, reminding us that squash is not just a game, but a true embodiment of camaraderie and fair play. I now request the chief guest to step on stage and felicitate the prize winners. First up, we have the prize winners of the under 12 category. The schools that participated in this category were DPS Arkepuram, New Delhi, Wellam Boys School, Dehradun, Daly College, Indore, the Emerald Heights International School, Indore, and Yadavendra Public School, Patiala. I shall first be announcing the individual positions. The winners are requested to step on stage as and when their names are announced. The gold medal has been bagged by Amarya Bajaj of DPS Arkepuram, New Delhi. The silver medal goes to Arav Agarwal of Daly College, Indore. And finally, the bronze medal is shared between Gurfarzand of YPS Patiala and Vihan Ramani of Daly College, Indore. Now moving on to the team positions, I request the coaches, managers and the officials to also step on stage along with their school teams to receive the awards. The second runners-up team goes to Wellam Boys School, Dehradun. The first runners-up team trophy goes to DPS Arkepuram, New Delhi. And finally, the winner's trophy has been won by Delhi College, Indore. Congratulations to the prize winners. With this, we move on to the under 14 category. The schools participating in the under 14 category are as follows: the Emerald Heights International School, Indore; Yadavindra Public School, Mohali; Assam Valley School, Assam; Yadavindra Public School, Patiala; the Dune School, Dehradun; Wellam Boys School, Dehradun; Modern School, Barakhamba Road, New Delhi; Mayo College, Ajmer; and Delhi College, Indore. The individual results are as follows. The gold medal has been bagged by Sir Harsh Shahara of Delhi College. The silver medal goes to Yukt Jaju of Delhi College, Indore. And finally, the bronze medal is shared between Divansh Agarwal of Modern School, Barakhamba Road, New Delhi, and Aname Rungta of Wellam Boys, Dehradun. The team positions are as follows. The second runners-up team goes to Wellam Boys School, Dehradun. The first runners-up team trophy goes to Yadavindra Public School, Patiala. The winner's trophy has been won by Daly College, Indore. Coming up next, we have the winners of the under 17 category. The schools that participated in the under 17 boys category were as follows: Modern School, Barakhamba Road, New Delhi; DPS Arkepuram, New Delhi; Assam Valley School, Assam; Yadavindra Public School, Patiala; the Dune School, Dehradun; LK Singhania, Rajasthan; Wellam Boys School, Dehradun; the Emerald Heights International School, Indore; Mayo College, Ajmer; Daly College, Indore; and RIMC, Dehradun. The individual results are as follows. The gold medal has been bagged by R.A.V. Divan of DPS Arkepuram. The silver medal goes to Yuvaditya Jain of DPS Arkepuram. And finally, the bronze medal is shared between Prakhar Lohia of Wellam Boys, Dehradun, and Paritosh Kohli of Mayo College, Ajmer. The team positions are as follows. The second runners-up team trophy goes to RIMC Dehradun. The first runners-up team trophy has been bagged by Vellum Boys School, Dehradun. The winner's trophy for this category has been won by DPS RK Puram, New Delhi. Last but not the least, we have the prize winners of the under-19 category. The schools that participated in the under-19 boys category were Modern School, Barakhamba Road, New Delhi, the Dune School, Dehradun, Daly College, Indore, DPS RK Puram, New Delhi, Yadavendra Public School, Patiala, and LK Singhania, Rajasthan. The individual positions are as follows. The gold medal has been bagged by Abhyuday Singh of Daly College, Indore. silver medal goes to Dhananjay Gupta of Yadavendra Public School, Patiala. And finally, the bronze medal is shared between Hiren Jain of Yadavendra Public School, Patiala, and Manit Gupta of Daly College, Indore. The team positions are as follows. The second runners-up team goes to the Dune School, Dehradun. The first runners-up team trophy is won by Yadavendra Public School, Patiala. And finally, the winner's trophy for the under-19 boys category goes to Daly College, Indore. With this, we come to the end of the prize distribution ceremony. Congratulations to all the winners. As we bring this tournament to a close, it is our fervent hope that you carry with you the memories of the exhilarating matches, the bonds forged, and the lessons learned. I request the chief guest to present souvenirs to the match officials who so benevolently spared their valuable time to judge the matches. I first call upon Mr. Sandeep Singh to receive his souvenir. I request Mr. Akhilesh Kumar to step forward. I request Mr. Shubham to step on stage. Next, I call upon Mr. Abhishek to step on stage. And finally, I request Mr. Piyush Sharma to accept his token of gratitude. I now request our school director to present a token of our gratitude to our esteemed chief guest. I request the chief guest to address the gathering and declare the All India IPSC Boys Squash Tournament 2023 closed.
Good afternoon, everyone. At the outset, I would like to thank Director Chan Garewal to invite me here and give me this opportunity to interact with all of you, especially young players who come from all over the country to represent their school and participate in this IPSC squash tournament. Nice to see tournament of all age categories and a lot of participants who have been here in Patiala and enjoyed their stay here. It's a very welcome step, especially during our school time when we organize such kind of tournament, and especially a school who is hosting it. Hosting a tournament at the Olympic level or a national level or at a school level, it takes all the effort. So first, let me congratulate each one of you who were part of the organizing team, the team who were doing the management in terms of conducting the tournament, looking after these students, managers, coaches, also the participants who have come all the way. Their summer holidays, summer break, this auditorium would have been full. Just because it's the summer holidays, the audience is less, but still the passionate people are here. And I would like to congratulate each and every participant who have come here, worked hard, and made this tournament successful. Parents, I can see many parents who are here. They've come all the way to see the performance of their child, the competition, and also to help us out to reach or to take this talent to a highest level. So I'm grateful to the parents who are here and who have joined us through this tournament. I'm here and I'm very happy that principals have invited me, because this is an opportunity where I can interact with students as sportsperson, with parents who are the motivators, or the person who is looking after their students and want to get them into the sports field. Also specialists, especially managers, coaches, PTI, who are basically developing the sports system in our country. So as senior executive director of NIS, I have an opportunity here to talk about few things as a sports. So just bear me for another few minutes, some important things which I can share with you. Sports in our country is picking up, and our ecosystem is really developing in a manner it should have been there in, I would say, in other countries. We have been getting less results at international level compared to many countries. So the reason behind this, that why we are not getting, is basically the sports ecosystem has certain gaps, and we know that what kind of gaps are there. Nowadays, these gaps have been identified by the sports coaches, administrator, schools, the units which are there in districts, states, or at a national level, we can call about Sports Authority of India or national federations. So we all together can bridge, or we can cover these gaps and develop a very strong sports ecosystem and a very good sports culture. So let's talk about few things about sports culture building up. I can see very many parents sitting here, and also good professional coaches who are there, and sports administrators are here with us. Sports is a very important part of our life, whether it's at a school level or slightly beyond it at the university level, or also in an organization where a lot of organizations are also helping or promoting sports. So at school level, a student, especially in a boarding school, he stays in a boarding school for nearly 8 to 9 years. If he is enrolled at the correct age, he passes out from the school at the age of 18 or 19. So his best time of his youth or a prime, or where he can develop his talent, is spent in school. And the schools who are having this kind of facilities are not very many, but definitely the talent in the school, and school, whether it is an urban school or a school in rural areas, or school in areas where not all development is not taking place, so the talent is available. The problem of our country is that we are not tapping the talent at the correct time, and we are not giving him the best. But now things are picking up. In NIS Patiala, we are making coaches. We are trying to make coaches who can have this kind of culture in schools, in areas where the sports have not reached. It is there in urban area, it is there only at very few places. So we are producing these kind of coaches. Just for your sake, I just want to give a small suggestion that wherever the talent is there, nowadays, that communication and the gap is reduced. You must identify that talent and get him to the best place, to the best coaches. A lot of academies have started, a lot of schemes of government is also working. Investing in sports by a parent, by a school, is worth investing in, as you say, you're comparing with studies, because it's sports who gives them multi-personality dimensions. It gives him more opportunity. Talking about opportunity in sports, as you are well aware that sports is growing, so after even 12th standard, there are a lot of education and sports promotional courses where he can build his career on, his or her career on sports field itself. We are running a lot of courses. Just name a few that we have got sports performance analysis. We have got coaching diploma courses. We have got sports science courses. We have got management courses. We have got a lot of skill development courses. Every kid wants to enjoy sports, and thereafter he wants to develop his career also in these fields. So just a small suggestion and advice that you should not close the avenues of a child, and you should give him exposure of these kind of avenues in sports ecosystem also, which is existing nowadays. We can share our website, we can share our thoughts, and definitely there are so many other organizations who can tell you about these kind of things. You are seeing Khelo India coming up in a big way. You are seeing a lot of money being spent by the state government and the central government. A child who's got a talent, he should not be stopped from playing games, because this is one thing which he will enjoy or cherish throughout his life. He can build his career if he is well equipped with other education and other part also, later on also. But if he is losing on the talent, and thereafter when he passes out from the school after 18 and 19, it is very difficult, very tough to again hone the skills of a sport. Thanks to such wonderful schools and schools who have participated here, everybody's got a facility of a squash court, they've got many squash courts. So these kind of facilities are not available to many talented kids. So just a small request to all these participants that they must work hard. They should try to excel wherever they are investing their time. Also, when studies are there, I've seen that they say sometimes parents blame that my kid was studying, that's why he's not scored well. It's not the reason. I always keep saying, नहीं पढ़ने से नंबर कम आते हैं, खेलने से नंबर कम नहीं आते हैं. So, नहीं पढ़ने से नंबर कम आएंगे, and खेलने से जो है नंबर कम नहीं आते हैं. खेलने से जो है बहुत सारी चीज़ें हमें अपने बच्चे की पर्सनैलिटी डेवलपमेंट, एंड यू सीन लॉट ऑफ केसेज. ऑल्सो इफ योर किड इज टैलेंटेड, दिस इज द राइट एज टू इन्वेस्ट इन योर टैलेंट. गिव हिम एवरीथिंग वॉट ही वॉन्ट्स. एंड स्पेशली द पार्टिसिपेंट जो यहाँ पे आए हैं स्क्वॉश में और एनी अदर गेम्स, देर आर सो मेनी अपॉर्चुनिटीज अवेलेबल. देर अराउंड 36 गेम्स विच आर ओलंपिक गेम्स. यू कैन पार्टिसिपेट इन 36. देर आर सो मेनी इंडिजिनियस गेम्स विच आर अवेलेबल विच विल कीप योर आई वुड से पर्सनैलिटी एंड ओवरऑल डेवलपमेंट ऑन राइट ट्रैक वैन यू गेट इन योर सेल्फ इन्वेस्टेड इन टू द स्पोर्ट्स. सो माई रिक्वेस्ट टू पेरेंट्स इज गिव अपॉर्चुनिटी टू द चाइल्ड वैन ही इज प्लेइंग स्पोर्ट्स. करियर इन स्पोर्ट्स is manifold, let him also enjoy. I've seen a lot of kids now part of football leagues, volleyball leagues, handball leagues, earning much more what we are getting at this stage also. We have been working on small kids who get passionate about sports. The classic example of Neeraj Chopra, he was nowhere in the sports till the time he was 15-16. Thereafter he saw that there's some talent in him, the coach identified him, and thereafter there was no stopping, and you could get a gold medal in Olympics. So that's the kind of talent what we have in our generation, in our youngsters, and getting more medals for our country should be our dream. And nowadays I think there's a lot of support from school organization, and especially from the parents, that they give everything. They say, okay, don't worry, and you just go and play sports. So we have seen parents like that who have been giving everything to their kids, and definitely even kids giving them back, whether it's the national level or international level. So that's the satisfaction what parents get when he sees that a talent has been nurtured and thereafter given everything, and then it has delivered results. When the sports career is over, as I said, there are a lot of avenues available. I have not referred to the coaching part because that everybody knows, but apart from coaching, the management part, as a sports scientist, as a smart administrator, as an analyst, and a very good package is available. So basically for the students and the parents here, so don't restrict them to very few avenues of their future. And so sports is one field where we can grow and we can get a lot of dollars for the country. So that's all from my side. Being the director of NIS, I had to say a few things. But once again, a wonderful match shown by Dhananjay and his teammate. Finals, it was worth watching and we enjoyed it. A beautiful organization by the school. And I must thank our director, sir, General Grewal, sir, that in this summer vacation, getting the school opened up and making these arrangements and calling all the teachers. So once again, thank to all the teachers who have contributed for successful organization of this tournament. I thank everyone, and also I would like to, at the end, declare All India IPSC Boys Squash Tournament 2023 closed. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your words of encouragement. We have encapsulated the journey of the 5 days of the squash tournament in a short video presentation. Thank you. We hope you enjoyed watching the presentation as much as we did putting it together for you. I request the Director, Major General B.S. Garewal, to present the vote of thanks.
Very good afternoon to all of you. You've been a wonderful audience. You've been very patient. It is now my privilege to present a vote of thanks to everybody who has contributed towards the success of the tournament. I must say that the last 5 days has been an absolutely marvelous experience for us in YPS, because we've had the privilege of hosting this tournament in which the top schools of the country have taken part. We witnessed great games of squash played in the true spirit of sportsmanship. All the participants fought hard to win. Some won, others learned. For I believe that in sports, you do not have winners and losers. You have some who win and others who learn from the experience and get better. I would like to thank at the very outset all the young sportsmen who displayed their exemplary skills and, more importantly, gentlemanly conduct in the true spirit of sportsmanship throughout the tournament. May you go on to earn great laurels in the years ahead. The coaches who have accompanied the teams have been a tremendous help to us in the organization and conduct of the matches. I would like to thank all the coaches of the various schools for their guidance and cooperation. A special word of thanks for the officials who carried out their duties in such a painstaking and meticulous manner. Your contribution in making the tournament a success has been of immense value to us. To those parents who are present here today, and also to those parents who are not physically here but have taken the trouble to join us via the internet, I would like to say that your motivation is the driving force behind the success of your boys. Thank you for encouraging children to take up sports. Education in a good school should be holistic and not confined to academics in classrooms alone. Sports are indeed an integral part of education. So thank you, dear parents, for your support for the game. To my own faculty, who have worked so hard over the last few weeks to ensure the success of this tournament, I would like to say that you never cease to amaze me with your dedication and sincerity, which has been exemplary. I am cognizant of the hard work put in by all of you, and I salute your efforts with a deep sense of gratitude. Finally, my grateful thanks to our esteemed chief guest, Colonel Raj Singh Bishnoi, Senior Executive Director of the iconic National Institute of Sports, who has taken time out from his busy schedule to be with us today. Your presence, dear sir, at this closing ceremony and prize distribution is a source of great motivation and inspiration to our budding sportsmen. Your words of advice will surely be remembered by the young boys and will guide them to achieve great success in various sporting activities in the years ahead. Thank you very much, and we seek your continued support in the development of sports in our school. Thank you, everybody. Jai Hind. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, sir. With this, we come to the end of the closing ceremony. Kindly stand for the national anthem. I request the guests and the staff to join us for a cup of tea in the lobby downstairs. The squash players shall proceed to the central dining hall for lunch. Thank you and have a nice day.